Fresh Ideas, produced by Tandem Studios.
Welcome to the Fresh Ideas podcast with Tandem Studios here. I'm Toby Ricketts, science reporter for the day. And today with me is Don Eigler. And he's an IBM fellow and a pioneer in the art of nanotechnology. Welcome, Don.
Well, I'm glad to be here, Tony.
So you pioneered the use of nanotechnology back in the 80s. Can you explain what it is in 100 words or less?
Nanoscience and nanotechnology is it's a technology of building things at the length scale of maybe 5, 10 atoms across, the smallest structures that you can imagine building within individual atoms, with the idea that we can use that technology to do valuable things.
So what I'm doing right now is I'm controlling where the tip is in San Jose. So if I want it to be one atomic diameter over to the right, I'll just move it one atomic diameter over to the right. By now you should be saying to yourself, I think that guy's a control freak.
Now, your achievements pioneered, they've been compared to the Wright brothers' pioneering flight when you constructed the letters IBM out of 35 xenon atoms. What have been the implications of that development? What's it opened the doors to?
What it has really done is it has enabled us to learn things that we just could not learn otherwise. It's really been a very powerful tool in our laboratory. Think of it this way. How much do you do in your life where you put things where you want them to go, and instead of accepting where something else puts them where you want them to go? We build houses according to our own design. Now we can do things like that at the atomic scale, where we put the atoms where we would like them to go. And what's really valuable about that from science point of view is that allows us to do experiments, very special experiments, where we can learn a lot.
I know in science fiction they've talked about nanobots and things, machines constructed at that atomic level. How far off do you think that kind of technology is?
I don't think it's at all possible. The so-called self-replicating nanobots, I've looked at it. I know some very well-respected scientists, people who I really respect, who have tried to understand whether that's something that can happen or not. And nobody that I know of who I respect at that level thinks it's possible.
With the next click of the mouse, that robot is going to move the tip in close to the carbon monoxide molecule on the surface so that the force between the outermost atom on the tip and the carbon monoxide molecule is hopefully large enough for us to be able to slide that molecule along. So here goes the click of the mouse. Now with one more click of the mouse, the robot's going to pull the tip back, leave the molecule there, and then go back to scanning. You better be there.
So, looking forward to the future, what do you see as the most exciting potential use of this new technology, nanotechnology?
Probably the way it's going to impact our health and our lives. There are some very exciting new ways to deliver drugs, for instance, to deal with cancer, that utilize nanoscale structures that we built. There's some very exciting work in being able to reverse paralysis using nanofibrils that are made from new kinds of molecules that chemists have been able to build. I personally would love to have some new cartilage in my knees so I could ski the bumps and tract up powder again. And there's a very real hope that the properties of nanostructured materials will allow us to be able to construct synthetic cartilage to help out guys like me.
Cool. Well, thank you very much for coming to Christchurch and sharing all this information with people of Christchurch. How have you found the city? Do you like it?
Oh, I've been here several times before and I love it. I'll come down here anytime.
Great. Thanks very much for joining us today.
My pleasure.
Cool. Fresh Ideas, produced by Tandem Studios.